We're at the Philadelphia History Museum here on 7th Street for Photo Tour 2018, a Greek musical odyssey, 100 years of history in Philadelphia. With me, Harry Karapolitis, one of the members that's on exhibition and one of the speakers this evening. Harry, who's also a dear friend, is going to be telling us a little bit about this evening. First, tell us, Harry, how do you feel about seeing all this?
This is great. We have a great turnout, and it's really great to document the history of Greek music in Philadelphia. Like Tet said, it's 100 years, but there's been so many bands and musicians that have performed for all of our weddings and festivals and dances, and I'm really happy there's a great turnout here today.
What's your favorite part of this show? Is there a particular musician that kind of inspired you, this part of this?
Oh, of course, George Giordas. George Giordas Orchestra, when I was a little kid, about 8 years old, when he was playing at the Greek dances, I used to stand in front of the stage and just look up at him and say, oh, I love to do that. And then the rest is history, as they say.
This event is being sponsored by the Heritage Society. What kind of a organization is it, and do we need events like this more?
Of course. It's the Heritage Society is preserving the Greek-American experience in Philadelphia and the Delaware Valley. Last year we did the Greek-American immigrants experience. This year we're doing the Greek bands. We're going to be doing others the coming years. And this is the way that will preserve our history for our children, grandchildren, and for generations to come.
This is tremendous. I can't believe the turnout. It's in a beautiful place. The exhibit looks beautiful. Of course, the snacks don't always help, right? Everybody's going to line up for those. But I think everybody's having a good time, and it's nice to kind of unearth a lot of the stuff that we've missed for so many years.
Is there a particular musician that you have always wanted to meet that might even be here?
Well, one that I respected the most is George Giordas. I met George at a function at church, and he told me that he learned how to play bouzouki when he was like 40. That blows me away, because I've been in music all my life. I've been playing violin since I was 5. And it was work to learn how to play the bouzouki, and to do it at 40. Now I'm 50. There's no way I'm learning anything. I'm done learning, right? So I can't respect him enough, and I always like seeing him.
Πώς τα βλέπουμε?
Πάρα πολύ ωραία. Έχω μείνει έκπληκτος. Ωραία πράγματα που θα μείνουν στην ιστορία του ελληνισμού εδώ στη κοινότητα.
What particular part of the exhibit do you like the most?
The fact that you guys found all this history and that dates back to 50 years, and that's how organized it is.
What a turnout. It really is amazing. It's just, I can't say enough about it.
What do you think of the exhibition?
The exhibition is well done, very well done. I don't know where you got all these pictures and all these instruments and all the facts that you gathered together, but it's awesome.
Did you know any of these musicians on the wall?
Yes, all of them. Just about all of them.
They all learned something from you, I'm guessing.
No, I learned from them.
Tell us about playing music through your day. What was it like for you?
It was an experience that you can't explain it, what it was. It's just wonderful. It's just wonderful reminiscing about them.
Billy Phillips, your grandfather was a left-handed violinist, rebetiko player.
That's correct.
You have his picture here. You've got his violin here. How do you feel about it?
Well, he's a famous man in the Greek community in New York City, and came down here eventually to play. Played at my father's wedding here in Philadelphia.
Describe him to us. What kind of man was he?
He was a man of few words. Loved to eat. Chicken and rice, that was his favorite meal.
When you hear his recordings now, how do you feel?
I feel great. Yeah, I feel great. I have them all on CD. I transferred them over to a CD. And it's amazing how he plays. It's just that you don't hear that quality of music today from a violinist. You know, it's just amazing, you know, how he did it.
And looking around here tonight, you've shared your history with the community. How does that make you feel?
It makes me feel good. My history doesn't compare with some other people's history, like George Giordas and some other people, but I'm still young yet, you know. And yours.
All right, thanks for talking with us. Enjoy your evening.
Thank you, Ted.
What can I say? I mean, it brings back memories. I mean, we're going back, what, 40, 45 years ago? It's very sentimental. That's all I can tell you. And I'm glad that they put it together. I mean, I'm seeing people that I haven't seen for ages. It's a great feeling.
Are more of these types of events needed for us?
Absolutely. I think we should do more of these events and covering different
histories,
different cultural things that happen. I mean, it's a big, big thing for the Greek American community. I have my son here, who's 12 years old, who's impressed with all this.
Come on over. Come on, say, how do you feel about your dad?
Good.
What do you think when you look back at him there and you say, Dad, you had hair?
I don't know.
He was handsome, wasn't he?
Sure.
but for our children growing up, I mean, this is something that they're going to be able to look back 40, 50 years from now. And it's very important for our Greek culture.
It's a way for us to connect.
Absolutely.
Keep the culture alive and keep going.
And we need people like you. I mean it. I told you this before, that do a great job. So,
thank you. Thank
you. I'm serious when I say that.
Yeah, this is my father.
This is your father.
Yeah, Alex Zaharias.
So tell me, how do you feel about seeing this picture up?
Oh, it's amazing. It really, this whole, the history that is in this place is just amazing. And to have my father be a part of it, it's an honor. It really is an honor. I'm so overwhelmed with the history that we as Greeks have, and you don't realize it. You really don't realize it until you actually see it in the Greek heritage, the people that brought it together, and it's just amazing.
This event is being sponsored by the Heritage Society. Have you ever been to an event like this, or what do you think of this kind of cultural affair?
I think it's something that we as a culture need to have. And we need to bring it to the attention of our children. I brought my kids with me today so they can see this, so they can see the pride that we have as Greeks and our Greek American heritage, because they were born here and they need to know where we come from, where our roots are, and where do we go from here. And it's good to see all of this in one place.
What do you think tonight of this entire fair? What's it like?
I'm impressed by how much work has been done by people that are just donating their time, like me. But a lot of other people are donating much more time than I am.
What musician did you happen to notice here tonight that might have influenced you or that you really admire?
Alex Zaharias, clarinet player, one of the first musicians that I started playing with about 1971 or two in Philadelphia. Alekos Zaharias, clarino, ωραίος άνθρωπος. He had a beautiful wife.
Great job. Κάνατε πολύ καλή δουλειά, Λευτέρη. Συγχαρητήρια.
Εδώ μέσα που τους βλέπεις τους άλλους, υπάρχει έναν που τον κάνεις λίγο admire, που λες he's good, I like his style. Κάπως έτσι που βλέπεις.
Ναι, το χάρι του Καραπαλίδη.
Το χάρι του Καραπαλίδη. Πώς το βλέπεις το θέμα?
Πολύ καλά, πολύ καλά. Πολύ μου άρεσε.
Χρειαζόμαστε τέτοια κάθε χρόνο να
κάθε χρόνο, ναι.
Κάτι για την κουλτούρα
μας. Ναι, κάτι για την κουλτούρα μας. Κάθε χρόνο να κάνουμε ένα τέτοιο, να θυμόμαστε τις παλιές εποχές και να μαθαίνουν και οι νέοι.
Να ξέρουν την ιστορία.
Να ξέρουν την ιστορία μας, ναι.
Πώς ήρθαμε εδώ, τι κάναμε.
Ναι. Είναι πολύ ωραίο city Φιλαδέλφια. Πρέπει να το παραδεχτούμε. Ένα από τα πιο όμορφα city που έχω πάει στην Αμερική. I love Philly.
Mary Paris gave us this wonderful photograph from the Greek radio station, which we wanted to mention thank you to, and who's here tonight. This historic image is part of the museum's history now. Mary, could you show us the picture?
And my husband was the DJ for everybody that got married or had baptism.
Tell us about the photograph. Who's in it?
Well, my husband used to be the DJ when there was christenings and baptisms. The people rented him out and used to go with all these boxes of records and played at their things, at their receptions, and his own microphones and the own speakers and everything.
And who else is in this picture?
Giordas. When he was the famous singer of that time. And if you got up to dance, he would shut up and he would leave the stage. You weren't allowed to dance or anything. This was the comedian. He was like the Bob Hope of that time. And my sister-in-law he wanted to stay at the house, at the apartment, so she let him sleep over one night. And this was Frank Iskakis. This is my husband in the middle. You never saw my husband. In the middle with the Bill Parrish.
This is the first organization that I've ever been involved that has more non-Greek last names than Greek. That's awesome. That's how we inspire the third, fourth, and fifth generation to reconnect to the roots. Our community is volunteer-based, collaborative to develop sponsorship, and the Heritage Center programming, engaging, and inspire our groundbreaking thinking like this one with our ancestors as well as our cultural heroes. We invite you to work with us, support us, and tell your family story. That's history. That's how history is written. One story at a time, one conversation at a time, one hug at a time. Thank you, Lefteri, for the hug. Our society works on the premise that we all have special talents and skills. Those skills we share to make a stronger community that meets our goals, our organization needs. When we couple this along with the innate desire to give back to our common Philhellene thread, which inspires us to collaborate across generations and affiliate organizations like the ones that are participating here tonight, this community enriches our lives every day.
Please join me in thanking Nick Yantzos, a true Hellenic heritage hero. This is long overdue. Take it.